Brilliant news!
Did you know that the human body has gold in it? This gold helps keep our joints strong and flexible and helps our cells convert one kind of signal or stimulus into another. You may not think having gold in your body is that surprising. After all, our bodies have lots of different types of elements in them, so why not gold? Well, according to scientists, all the gold on Earth was formed in supernovae and neutron star collisions that occurred before the solar system was even formed. So how can we have it in our bodies? You may think that we consume it in our food or drink. But gold is extremely inert. You could eat a spoonful of gold powder every day for your whole life, and it would pass directly through you completely unchanged, and you wouldn't absorb any of it. It also has no taste or smell, so putting it on food is completely pointless. So maybe our bodies actually produce it. Despite what many alchemists believed for centuries, gold cannot be produced via chemistry or alchemy. Elements are defined by the number of protons they possess. Lead has the atomic number 82 and therefore has 82 protons, whereas gold has 79. Changing lead into gold requires changing the atomic proton number, and the number of protons in an element cannot be altered by any chemical means. Theoretically, it's possible to form gold through the nuclear processes of fusion, fission, and radioactive decay, although it's easiest for scientists to transmute gold by bombarding the heavier element, mercury, and producing gold via decay. But these processes require huge amounts of energy and obviously cannot happen within the human body. So how come every human has gold inside them, even a newborn baby? Well, babies receive nanoparticles of gold through their mother's milk. And these nanoparticles are small enough for our bodies to absorb. Nanoparticles of gold are actually present in seawater and the soil. So plants and animals absorb some of these gold nanoparticles, and then they are passed up the food chain to us. Our bodies carefully regulate the concentrations of these nanoparticles of gold and remove any surplus through our skin and hair. Babies under 3 months old have more gold in their hair than older people. At least 0.006 parts per million. And these levels may seem extremely low, but the average concentration of gold in the Earth's crust is only around 0.03 parts per million, about half that of babies' hair. So maybe we should be harvesting human hair instead of digging up the ground. Now that would make an interesting Discovery Channel show. Gold Rush, shaving babies.
Look at me, take a picture, it'll last longer. The mirror on the wall say I'm getting stronger. Ayo, the mirror don't lie. Ayo, the mirror don't lie. Look at me, take a picture, it'll last longer. The mirror on the wall say I'm getting stronger.